It's on a case-by-case basis.
And that is my point. Thank you for making it for me. Every kid thinks they're the exception to the rule. And members of the media like, Stephen A. Smith, are encouraging these kids to come out early.
Look, Max, bottom line is this. You got to take this into consideration. You had two dudes. They were called the Height Brothers. Now, you had Nick Howard. This kid had a lot of promise. What does he do? He goes to college. Very uneventful first year, no doubt. The second year, he was pretty good. Here's the problem. The NBA, it's not about pretty good. You need to be great on the collegiate level, on the prep level, in summer leagues and what have you, in order for you to get the stature that you deserve. That's the bottom line. You're pretty good ain't good enough to be that stud NBA.
That's my point. That's exactly my point.
Let me finish. There's another example. I did say the Hype Brothers. I wasn't talking about one individual. I was talking about two. What happens? One and done in a different way. 1 year, one ACL injury later, and look where he's at now. His future is clearly uncertain. So you got to take advantage of that opportunity because you never know when an injury is going to cost you everything.
Stephen A., listen to yourself. Let's listen to yourself for a second. You give one argument for why a kid should come out early, a one-and-done situation. I can give you 30 arguments this morning alone why they should stay in school. And now you have to wonder what a kid like Nick Howard, who has given up his college eligibility, does next. What does he do next?
First of all, don't sweat the technique. The argument, or one argument, as long as it's strong enough, that's all that matters. That's number one. Number two, the Hype Brothers was something special. What they really, really need to do, I'm going to tell you what they need to do, Max. They need to get back to playing together. My sources are telling me the ACL injury has been completely healed. So go on a pro-am circuit. Go in summer leagues. Do what you got to do to get back on the court together to remind everybody of what you once were. Because once you pull that off, the sky's the limit. That's what they need to do. Get back to playing ball together, because when people see what you can do as one, the other arguments don't really matter. Like I said, don't sweat the technique.
Yeah, yeah. Fendi. All these hundreds in my pocket, I'm getting plenty. Riding with me, and it's belly. I ain't it, but don't tell me. Every day another deposit, yeah. I just signed a deal with Kingston, I'm a designer, yeah. Loyalty, must and death before the signing, yeah. Real, I won't tell, I put that to my mama, yeah. Spent 3 bands on a Moncler, yeah. Walked out the store with that Moncler, yeah. And you know that number's on my back. I'm a hype beast, I know how to act. Yeah, they didn't get around money. Ever since I got it, I've been blowing money. Yeah, you a broke.
This is New York City, the mecca of basketball. The original Rucker League began here in 1947. 9 years later, the tournament found a permanent home uptown at PS 156 Playground. Those early Rucker days showcased talents like Lew Alcindor, Wilt the Stilt, and Earl the Pearl. It's also where Julius Erving became the Doctor. In 1974, the park was respectfully renamed Holcomb Rucker Park in honor of the tournament founder. Now, many have influenced the growth of the Rucker since, but none more heavily than the late great Greg Marius, founder of the EBC. Many would argue that the Ruck is the birthplace of true street ball and the crossover dribble. Considering New York City's penchant for flashy guard play, there are few who can challenge that. After the legendary exploits of Rucker alumni like Rod Strickland, Rafer Austin, and Kyrie Irving, it goes without saying that getting crossed up or banged on can happen to anybody at any given moment here. It's no wonder that this unassuming uptown playground has become the most widely recognized streetball court in the world. Rucker Park, Harlem.
Here we go, about to play at Rucker Park. Let's go ahead and take this W. All depend on the ball. That's not good. That is definitely not good. Try to cross him. He got me a clamp. I didn't go nowhere. Dang. What a putback. What a putback. Oh, I got that steal. Lay it. Too easy. I thought I was about to miss right there. I thought I was about to miss. I got ball. Pick up. Clamp. Ooh. Dang, he just got dunked on. Come on. What was that? Oh my goodness, bro. Sorry guys, I had to do something. Now I'm back. Push it. Oh, too easy. I'll take those all day. Come on, you can't let him score. Too easy. It is too easy out here. And one. Let's go. Too easy out here. What a pass. That was beautiful. You gotta make them. You just ruined my assist, bro. Messed up. In your mouth? Oh. Oh, got the rebound back. Oh, turn over the ball. That was my fault. Oh, man. You didn't score off the turnover. Too easy. Too easy. These layups, I take those all day. Ooh, wide open. Mid-range. Oh, golly. I missed that. Your defense. Oh, I got blocked. That's embarrassing. He just got blocked. Lamp. He got blocked. That's two blocks in my team. A layup. Oh, I missed the layup. But I ripped him though. Recover? I just recovered. Yep, made that layup. Let's go. Guard it. Come on, man. Can't stop that. Post. Ooh. Too easy. Going layups on you all day. All day. Give me them. Go. Oh, I turned over the ball. But they ran out of bounds, though. Little ball. Come on. In your mouth. Oh. Ooh, what a dunk. Good dunk. Snap. Rip. Aw, are you serious? Nobody could touch that. Man. I'm gonna get him back. Like I said, game. Let's go. All I take is W. Come on. Game.